Hello everyone, this is Dr. Iman from Partha Dental, Bangalore, India, reaching out to the masses live. Today, we are here to give you some insights about preventive and pediatric dentistry. And we have Dr. Anandita, who is a senior periodontist here with me, okay? Dr. Anandita has been doing a lot of cases off late on pediatric dentistry, and she would like to give us some insights on the various new technology and the products available today in the market for children. And she's going to be giving you a lot of insights on sealants, on habit breaking appliances, and fluoride therapy. Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining in today. Yes, so basically before we start, I would like to tell you something about Partha Dental. We are a chain of corporate dental clinics spread across Hyderabad, Telangana, and the city of Bangalore. We have about 30 plus clinics in Hyderabad, 40 in Telangana, and 12 plus clinics and many more to come. We are the largest chain of dental clinics in South India. Talking about our achievements, we are a massive force of dentists, and we have about 300 plus doctors, specialists, and we have a huge setup. We have been rewarded as the best dental chain of clinics, and we have gone up to winning the Oscar awards for the best chain of dental clinics in India. So far we have done the highest number of smile designs, and we have done the maximum number of implants all over India. And it's like we have been achieving, we have been crossing a lot of milestones in the field of dentistry on and off from the past 20 years. We have about 20 years of work expertise in the field of dentistry. We have been doing this public awareness past months, and I would like to give you some insights about the speakers who will be joining us this week. We have Dr. Satya Kiran, who is a senior oral pathologist, and we have Dr. Vijay Kumar, who is a senior implantologist and a very omniscient speaker. Dr. Tanuja, who is a cosmetic dental surgeon and who has specialized in radiology. We have Dr. Abhiruchi, who is a senior cosmetic dentist and who has achieved a lot of milestones, who has crossed a lot of milestones in her career, and she'll be sharing her experiences with us. She's one of the most omniscient speakers that we have. And then we have Dr. Aditi Nathekar and Dr. Manu, both of them who are senior cosmetic dentists as well as implantologists. So basically this awareness camp is for the public, wherein you can ask us as many questions as you want, and you can hear all the doubts that you have been having all these years, which you would like to have discussed with your dentist so far. So welcome all of you. Thank you for joining in. Now over to Dr. Anandita.
Thank you so much, Dr. Iman. Hi everyone, this is Dr. Anandita, senior periodontist working for Partha Dental, Bangalore, India. Pediatric dentistry, when Dr. Iman came to me and said that we want to do an awareness program on pediatric dentistry, I was very happy, because usually we patients think that child dentistry is not so important, or primary teeth, or rather the milk tooth, due to treatment, to spend money and to take care of them is not a very important aspect. But today I'm here to clear the doubts, to bust out all the myths, So you can shoot all your questions, all your queries to me, and I would be giving you all my answers to the best of my knowledge.
Thank you so much, Dr. Anandita. So when it comes to your child, okay, we parents tend to give the best of the best education, the best of the best skills when it comes to sports or, you know, debates or stage shows, whatsoever. But then we have seen a lag.
Yeah.
When it comes to your overall health of your, you know, overall well-being of your child. And it has come to our notice that a lot of parents don't have they are not educated when it comes to oral hygiene.
Yes.
Basically, your mouth is a mirror of your body. And, you know, oral hygiene plays a very important role when it comes to your overall health of your child. So today we'll be sharing you a few techniques wherein you can help your child to brush 2 times a day, and you can help your child to have a positive attitude when it comes to have this fear towards dentists. So I would like to say that children from the age of 6 months, you know, toddlers from the age of 6 months to 12 years, there are a lot of techniques which we parents can follow to actually encourage them to themselves walk into Partha Dental and do the treatments with us. Okay, so Dr. Anandita, what about this pit and fissure sealants? Okay, how does it help when it comes to the cavities?
Yeah.
How does pit and fissure sealant help us to prevent any further problems when it comes to our child?
First of all, I would like to say that the first dental visit of your child should be at, as Dr. Iman said, 6 months of age. Why? Because the first teeth, the eruption of the first teeth, will happen at that age. So it is very important to go to the dentist and get everything checked.
All right.
So at that age, okay, we always keep a note of the anatomy of your tooth. Okay, how the structure of the tooth is. Every tooth is different. Every one of us is unique. Our tooth is also different. So some people have deeper structures. Okay, deeper structures in the sense they have a depression in the surface.
So you mean to say something like this?
Yes.
When you have these pits which are naturally formed during child development.
Yes.
All right. So we have pits as in so.
These are like certain depressions which become a niche for food accumulation, because our child do not understand the importance of brushing, the importance of keeping his teeth clean. So as a result, what happens? Whatever he eats, it gets accumulated on the tooth, and the caries starts right at the center of the tooth. Why? Because it is the deepest most point. Now, with pit and fissure sealant, what we can do is we can apply this. This is the normal tooth, okay, with all these grooves and the fissures and the pits. Okay, now we have applied a material called pit and fissure sealant. What it will do, as its name suggests, very simple concept, it will seal. Okay, it will seal the depression. As a result, your food cannot go and collect on those depressions. This is a preventive method, and it is very, very advisable in the young generation. Why? Because when we were kids, these things were not there. So finally, we had to go for fillings. We had to go for root canal treatment. But our children, today we have the knowledge, we have the procedure, we have pediatric dentists, we have Partha Dental. So we are here to prevent that. We don't want our children to undergo the same kind of things that we have undergone after 10 years. When we can prevent it today, right, doctor?
Yes, yes, yes.
So pit and fissure sealants, if you... can be applied only when you take your child to the dentist. The dentist has to advise it, and they can be treated.
Yeah, I remember a parent came to me saying that my son brushes 2 times a day, but yet he has these caries, and how am I going to stop it? Okay, how am I going to stop these caries from progressing? Okay, so we have the pit and fissure sealants that we do in Partha Dental.
So this was done in our clinic. Okay, as you can see, the white color material. Okay, the white color material. So it is tooth colored. So it is not very visible, not very conspicuous. The child will not be conscious. You know, this is also a very important aspect of pediatric dentistry. Whenever we are doing some treatment, the child should not feel that, you know, he, you know, something different is happening to me.
Okay, is it painful?
No, not at all. It is not painful. And
what is it made up of?
It is a polymerizing resin, but the thing is, it is FDA approved, so it is not to worry, nothing to worry about it. It's a very, very safe material which can be used in children.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Anandita. Mm-hmm. Now, when it comes to you know, preventive dentistry, what are the various measures that we can follow mm-hmm. for our children? Mm-hmm. Do you have some kind of a therapy, or can you please tell us?
Yes, so this basic thing starts from a dental home. Now, what is a dental home? It comprises of the patient, that is the child, the dentist, and the parent. The parent is always involved whenever okay. we are talking about pediatric dentistry.
Yeah.
Okay, so it starts from the regular brushing, flossing, and all those things. Apart from that, you should get your regular fillings done. Okay, there should not be any caries in the mouth, because caries is nothing but an infection. Do we like infection in the body?
No.
Then why the mouth? Why the mouth? No, we are not supposed to keep any infection in the mouth. We should get rid of all the caries. And at the end of the treatment, we should have a fluoride application therapy.
What is the procedure for this fluoride application?
See, the procedure is very simple. The fluoride is a material, is a substance which helps to make the tooth stronger by combining with the enamel, and it forms a complex called fluoroapatite. Now, this fluoroapatite is very acid resistant, and what happens, even though unknowingly we consume a lot of acidic drinks, acidic food, like soft drinks. Nowadays our children goes to Burger King and McDonald's, and always are on cola and Pepsi. So all this is, even though superficially we see that nothing has happened, everything is fine, but yes, there is always some micro destruction to the tooth each time your child is sipping the cola.
Okay.
So if we put fluoride,
okay,
if we subject the teeth to fluoride, what will happen? The fluoride is a mineral which is a very, very nice mineral which will go and just bond to your tooth structure and form a very hard surface, and it will become acid resistant.
So you mean to say the child will never have caries after that?
No, I cannot assure that you will never have caries, but yes, there will be 80% decrease. The study says 80% decrease in the formation of caries after the fluoride application.
Okay. So as in when a parent notices something like, you know,
yes.
you have something like a small pit or even a small cavity, you can just come for a consultation. How often should a child come for a dental checkup?
Every 6 months.
Every six months.
Because there are a lot of changes happening in his mouth, you know. It is not like how our mouth is. Mm-hmm. We have a set of teeth, and it is not going to shed off or come. It is just there. Mm-hmm. So we need to go for a regular checkup, as we say. But for a child, because he doesn't know, he cannot tell whether there's a caries or there is some kind of irritation. Mm-hmm. It is the parent's duty to get him to the dental every 6 months.
Okay, that's great. Thank you so much. We have a question here from Mr. Indranil. Hi, doctor. What is a space maintainer appliance? Can we give it for an 8-year-old kid?
Yeah. Thank you, Indranil, for asking such a lovely question. Space maintainer, as the name suggests, it is to maintain the space after the loss of your primary tooth. Okay, now suppose, as I say, if we don't prevent the caries of happening, what happens? The consequences, we will lose the tooth. Okay, now when we lose the tooth because of caries, if it is because of the normal chronology, normal shedding time, then there is no need of space maintainer. But if for any other reason, be it trauma, it can be a fracture, it can be a caries, or all those reasons, if we have lost the tooth, we need to put a space maintainer which will maintain the space for the eruption of the permanent tooth, right? If there is no space, what happens? Our teeth are very inclined to move towards each other. It will close the space. When it closes the space, there is no area for the new tooth to erupt.
So here we have a picture. Yes.
So this is a space maintainer. So what has happened in this kid? I don't know. So can you hold it for me?
Yeah.
Thank you so much, doctor. So what has happened here, as we can see, the child has lost one tooth in the middle. Okay. So what has happened to maintain that area, to maintain that distance between those two teeth, so that when the permanent tooth erupts, it has sufficient space and there is not any kind of malocclusion. Malocclusion in the sense, it is like irregularity in the placement of your teeth. Okay. So for that, it's a very simple stainless steel device, just a band around the permanent tooth, and there is a wire element. Okay, this is the second. Yeah, this is the band. Okay, this is your wire element. So once we see, this is the space for your new tooth to come up or to erupt. So once we see that there is an eruption, a little bit clinically it is visible, immediately what we will do, we will remove the space maintainer and we let the tooth erupt beautifully in that space, so that he doesn't have to undergo any orthodontic treatment later on because of the malpositioning of the tooth.
So basically parents can prevent orthodontic treatment because they're preventing the shift of the adjacent teeth. So in case aapke bacche ka jo daant hai wo jhad jata hai naturally ya kisi accident se ya kuch bhi trauma ya caries se hame usko you know unfortunately usko nikalna padta hai to uske jagah mein we have to give a space maintainer. Okay, this maintains the required space for the future secondary teeth to erupt, and we can avoid orthodontic corrections. Orthodontic corrections tab hote hain jab you know the jaw mein space nahi hota hai, we do not have enough space and one teeth comes on top of the other. So basically, if you have enough of space for the permanent teeth to erupt, you don't have to go in for the orthodontic treatment. And we still have many other solutions. For that, please get in touch with us today to www.parthadental.com, or please call us to our toll-free number 1-800-102-8686. All right, we have
another question.
Thank you so much for joining in, everyone, today. We have
another question from an engineer. Can we give implant in 10-year kid with missing permanent front teeth? Okay, that's a very interesting question, Mr. Engineer. Thank you for asking that. Yes, implant is an option. Pediatric implants do exist. But the thing is, my personal opinion and also from the research studies what we have seen, it's always advisable to do the implant after the canine eruption. Because till this, the cornerstones, okay, this is called canine, this, yes, we can show this tooth, okay, this tooth is in this area, the canine, okay, the cornerstone of the jaw. So till that erupts, so that will erupt around like 12 years of age, like, 11 to 12 years of age. So it is always advisable that there's a, the occlusion or the, what is it, alignment. Okay, the alignment of the teeth is settled. We know how his occlusion or the alignment of the teeth are going to be, and it is advisable that after that only we place an implant. And as for the replacement, if your child is not having the permanent front teeth, there is a replacement. We can go for bridges, we can go for removable appliances, and we can also do it's called a riband material. So with riband, what we do is we do not actually prepare a bridge, but we can temporarily give the front teeth which does not have much loading. So there are solutions, not to worry if the permanent front teeth are missing. There are a lot of solutions in pediatric dentistry. You can definitely visit our clinic. I'll be there to help you out, and we can really restore the beautiful smile of the kid.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Anandita. Now I would like to talk about the various malfunctions or the habits that children have which you must have not even noticed as a parent, okay, but it is leading to a lot of hazards for the child when it comes to having a perfect occlusion. Okay, these are called oral habits?
Yes.
Yeah. So what there are various options, various sciences available today in the market to break these oral habits. As in, we have the tongue thrusting. One second, I show you this. Yeah. We have habits like the tongue thrusting. Okay. Children who have an open bite, they are actually using their tongue to push their teeth in front. And over a period of time, it develops into a gap in the front teeth. Okay, it can be towards the side as well. We have a side open bite or we have a front open bite. So Dr. Anandita, can you tell me what is the solution for this kind of tongue thrusting that children do? It starts at the age of 6, I believe.
Yes, yeah. Yes. But the moment there is permanent dentition, as I said, a lot of changes will happen in the kid's mouth. Okay. His primary teeth will fall off, his new teeth will come. So he's always adjusting. Even the sizes of the structure will increase, the tongue size, the jaw size. So these habits, as we are talking about habits, habits is nothing but something we do regularly. Now this can be intentional and non-intentional. Now we have to check first what kind of a habit it is. Because sometimes what happens for children who has airway obstruction, suppose we have, there's a deformity in the nose and the child is not able to breathe properly from the nose. So what happens? He will keep his mouth open to breathe. Okay. So that is like an unintentional habit, because the child is trying to breathe from his mouth.
So jab bhi aap dekhte hain ki aapke bacche ka kabhi naak band ho jata hai, to automatically apne muh se saans lene lag jata hai. The child starts breathing from the mouth because his nose is clogged. Okay. So parents have to keep a close watch on all these small findings, symptoms of mouth breathing. Okay. Now, basically, there are many solutions to solve these problems. Can you tell us what happens exactly? What are the symptoms?
What are the disadvantages?
What are the symptoms that parents how can they detect mouth breathing?
Yes, it's a very simple test. It's like you will see all the every time your child is opening, keep his mouth open, especially during sleep. Okay, if he is not having a lip closure, that is your lips are not closing. See, this is a perfect lip seal. Okay, if he is not doing that, that means he is breathing from his mouth. Okay, now in that sequence also, he is not positioning his tongue properly. He's pushing the teeth, like pushing the teeth. So what happens in this? It is definitely, it's a very simple logic. There's nothing, very great in it. So when you are continuously pushing your front teeth, it will come out. It will come out.
Okay? Something like this?
Yes, it will come out. So what will happen? Eventually, the child's occlusion, the appearance, the position of the teeth, everything is going to become irregular. Okay? It will become forward placed. So if we stop the habit, if the moment you notice this habit, if you stop the habit, then we are going to be able to restrict that malocclusion or the forward placement of the teeth and this the entire front region. Okay, that whatever the appearance will change, so we can prevent that. So now this is a appliance. It is called tongue grip. Okay. So can you see, this is stainless steel wire which are formed in loops, so that every time the child tries to push his teeth with the tongue, it is going to act as a wall, as a barrier. And obviously it is not going to be a very pleasant effect when he touches this stainless steel wires. And he will eventually stop the habit and his occlusion or his teeth, which were being constantly pushed, the force will be relieved and the teeth will go backwards automatically, and the problem will be solved.
Okay. So it can be given for the upper teeth as well as for the lower teeth.
Yes.
Okay. This is one of the cases that we have done in Partha Dental, wherein we have given tongue grips for the lower teeth. Because the child had a habit of pushing his teeth because he had a huge tongue. It's called macroglossia. Okay. The child was continuously pushing his lower teeth unconsciously during his sleep. So the parents decided to go in for something like the tongue crypts. Okay.
So after that, we have other appliances also. As we can see, this is called a tongue roller. Okay. If you are worried that no, we don't want to put those loops into the child, there is a roller. So what happens in that? The child starts playing with the roller. It is a new habit, but which is less damaging from the first habit. This is called blue grass appliance or the roller, tongue roller. And with this also we can prevent the habit.
So doctor, how long does it take for a parent to get this appliance from Partha Dental?
Very, very few days, you know, maybe a day or a couple of days, 2 days.
In 2 days, we deliver this appliance. Yes. In case your child has such an issue,
2 days.
Within 2 days, you can get this appliance today. So please come visit us to our clinics. All right. Now, when it comes to oral habits, okay, the most hazardous one would be the thumb sucking habit. All right. We have the thumb sucking, which is very commonly seen, in India. Right.
So, like till, I would also like to tell the tell our viewers that till 4 years of age, it is normal, 3 to 4 years of age, because they have that urge of sucking, because they are always, you know, they are on breastfed, and then they go to the pacifier. So it's a very natural habit. But after 4 years of age, if you still see that your child is falling asleep with his tongue or with his thumb or any finger with the finger in the mouth, then it is really, really critical.
Yeah, as you can see, there are a lot of side effects for this kind of an oral habit. Okay, children who tend to do thumb sucking will have forwardly placed front teeth, and they will, you know, have continuous. This is
The digit. The digit will obviously, if you are always in the
sucking,
it is in contact with your saliva. Area will always get degraded, okay, because we'll be pushing it. And the concept is as simple as the earlier one, the tongue pushing. It is just instead of the tongue, the child is applying force with the help of his thumb. So the results are same.
What are the harmful effects of thumb sucking?
It's the same as I told. Your tooth will be forwardly placed because you're constantly pushing the front teeth with the thumb.
Okay. Does it affect the confidence of the child?
Yes. As far as child psychology goes, it's a very huge topic, but I would like to brief it up. So this, what happens is when he starts doing such habits, okay, be it mouth breathing or thumb sucking or tongue thrusting, what happens? Other children starts making fun of him. And what he sees is his teeth are not similar to other children's teeth. As a result of what? He's always conscious of himself. So it can affect his personality, his confidence level, his public appearance, his public speaking. We see, you know, children are shy to come out and, you know, to talk to others. So mostly it is because of appearance and comparison. So we need to stop the
So it basically it hampers their confidence when it comes to facing the outside world.
Yes.
So we have to ask them to stop it, or we have to get some kind of a solution from us, from a dentist, and it will really make a difference to the child's life. The child may not even mention about what difference it has made to him, but you will see the change in your child as he stops these oral habits over a period of time. All right, we have some people who are joining in. Thank you so much for joining in today. We have Miss
Okay, Shakti Fazal has joined. Anu Rijo has joined.
Hi, doctor. When can we start orthodontic treatment in kids?
Hi, Anu. Thanks for asking that question. Orthodontic treatment, as I said, I always prefer that at the very beginning of the malocclusion, the moment you see that something is not aligned, okay, that something is not aligned or straight in your child's teeth or the arrangement of the teeth, first you should take him to the dentist and go for an interseptic orthodontics. Now, what is this interseptic orthodontics? It is something we do to cut short your the adult orthodontics. Okay, it is done in a mixed dentition period. Oh, now, what is a mixed dentition period? There will be a time, a transition time when your child will have primary teeth, that is a milk teeth, and also the permanent ones. So, in that stage, if you go for an interceptive orthodontic, it becomes easier for the child. Sometimes minor corrections will be happening with the interceptive orthodontics itself. But if the case is very severe, if there is a skeletal skeletal anomaly, then I would suggest, yes, you have to go for a adult orthodontics. We can start it from the age of 12.
Okay, we can start doing the orthodontic procedure
from the age of 12. As I told, the canine eruption, it's a very important part when we talk about pediatric dentistry. So once the cornerstones and the bite and the alignment is established, we know how it is going to be, we can start with the orthodontics.
Okay, here we have someone called is Tanuja, who has asked us, how often can my child visit the dentist?
Yes. Hi, Tanuja. Thank you for asking that question. I would say that, as I told you, every 6 months it is advisable for your child to visit the dentist, because he may not have any caries, he may not develop any caries, but it is very important for the child to remember his dentist and the dental visit. Because what happens usually, if you give a very long gap, the child will forget.
Okay.
And every time he comes, there will be anxiety, there will be fear, you know, he'll be very hesitant. So it's better that you take him every 6 months, so that he has a memory that, yes, she's my dentist or he's my dentist, and she's very friendly. And so that when there is actually some problem and the treatment has to be done, the child is comfortable, he's acclimatized to the situation, he knows the environment, and he'll be happy.
Okay, thank you so much. So this Mr. Indranil is asking, can we give ceramic space maintainers?
Yes, we can give ceramic space maintainers, as I told, but that we cannot give the one I have shown you with the band. Okay, it is a stainless steel band. So when we want ceramic space maintainer, we have to give a crown. Okay, we have to give a cap. Now, when we give a cap to a child, when the tooth has gone for a root canal treatment. Now, you must be wondering, oh my God, for primary teeth also there is root canal treatment. But yes, there is. When the caries is very deep, it has to go for a root canal treatment. So in children, we call it pulpectomy. So whenever there is this pulpectomy procedure done, we advise to protect the tooth with a crown. So that crown can be given with the ceramic material.
Can you see that there are different kinds of crowns available in Partha Dental?
Okay. These are ceramic zirconia crowns, because nowadays, children are very conscious about their looks. They don't want stainless steel crowns.
These are the stainless steel crowns.
Yes. These are the stainless steel crowns. They are non-allergic, and there is to help and protect the tooth. As I said, it is very important for the child to preserve all the tooth, all the teeth in the mouth, to have a good nutrition.
Okay, thank you so much. So coming back to the thumb sucking habit, okay, there is a very good appliance that we have available today in Partha Dental. It's called the thumb guard. Okay, it's called the thumb guard. As you can see, you have finger guards as well. So the children can stop sucking on their fingers or their thumb when they have this barrier. They'll be like, ugh, okay, I don't want to suck my thumb anymore. So there are various appliances available today, and which are all available in Partha Dental, and we could deliver to you at a very short period of time.
So it is customizable depending on the size of the finger, because these are available in the market also. But I would not recommend those, because we don't know the material it has been made of, whether it is FDA approved, you know, and also it will not fit the child properly. So if you visit a dentist, especially us, we can customize it for your child, the thumb guard, which, is specifically made for your child, which is advisable.
Thank you so much. And now coming to the other oral habits, we have...
Okay, Rajkumar Bose has joined. Hello. Satya Narayana has joined. Hi. Ramesh Babu has joined. Sujata Ji has joined. Thank you. Welcome all. I'm Dr. Anindita Sharma. periodontist from Partha Dental, Bangalore, India. And Dr. Iman is here. And today we are talking about pediatric and preventive dentistry. Any questions, you can shoot on to us and we will answer your questions.
Okay. Again, Mr. Indraneel asks us, what is an open bite? Okay. Now, as we said, an open bite is something that is whenever there is a space between the front teeth or the side teeth, it is called an open bite. Okay. So it's something like this, sir. And there are a lot of oral habits that lead to this front bite. Most of the time it's because the child tends to push the teeth with his tongue. Okay, so it causes changes in the overall musculature, the muscles, the tongue, the bone, everything gets impacted because of the tongue thrusting habit. And then we have habits like the thumb sucking, which leads to an open bite. So open bite is basically when there is a spacing between the front, upper and lower teeth. So doctor, is there any orthodontic solution for the open bite?
Yes, like orthodontic solution, yes, we can put the braces, okay. And also we can, that's a good appliance. Okay, now this is called a pre-orthodontic trainer. Now what happens is this, is like we train the muscles, okay. We train the muscles not to put much of pressure on the teeth and to align the teeth so that they occlude or they join each other, because we want, because when there is a gap, what we are saying, the open bite, there will be a gap, the teeth will not join each other. To make them join each other, to make them align with each other, we can use this pre-orthodontic trainer. Apart from it, we have different appliances. Okay, like we have
to correct the open bite.
Yes, we can use bite plane, the posterior bite planes, and we can also use elastics. Okay. Normal orthodontic treatment also can be.
Okay, now coming to the next.
I think Indraneel has another question about cleft lip and palate treatment available in your hospital. Yes, sir. Cleft lip and palate treatment is available in our hospital. Actually, there are different phases. It's not a one particular dentist who will do a cleft lip and palate treatment. We have a skilled team. We have a team of skilled doctors, in which there will be a periodontist, there will be a surgeon, there will be an orthodontist, there will be a preventive dentist, because it's a very total kind of comprehensive. It's a comprehensive treatment.
Yeah, it requires a lot of expertise to correct a cleft lip or palate, and we have to have a pre-anesthetic examination done. We have to, check the child's blood samples. Everything has to be done, very professionally, which is done in Partha Dental.
Yes.
And we have been having such cases in our Hyderabad zone, and we have Dr. Vijay Kumar, who's been doing cleft lip operations on and off. He'll be talking about the cleft lip operations that he's been doing in Partha Dental in the coming days. And the cleft lip and palate treatment, yes, it is definitely available in Partha Dental, sir. Thank you for asking the question.
Yes, I would like to show them this appliance. This is a maxillary expansion appliance. As you can see, what happens in cleft lip and palate patient, the maxilla, the upper bone, is collapsed, okay? Because there's a cleft, right? There's a cleft is nothing but a division, okay? Since there's a division, it is compressed. So we need to enlarge it. We need to expand it. Now this is the maxillary expander, and we have been practicing this for a long time. But as I told, it is a very comprehensive treatment. We need the opinion. We need the doctors of other specialty apart from periodontics, and we will welcome every cleft lip and palate child to Partha Dental, because we really have a good team for it, and we can deliver good results in a very short time.
Okay. The next oral habit that I would like to bring your attention to is the lip biting habit. Certain children, out of nervousness, they tend to bite on the lower lip or upper lip. Okay. So that leads to a lot of injuries, and it leads to ulcers and many other complications. So doctor, do you have a solution for
lip biting?
Lip biting,
yes. Lip biting can be avoided with an appliance called lip bumper. Okay. Then we can also use our pre-orthodontic trainer, as I showed you, because that is going to obstruct the lip. Okay.
Lip biting inhibitor, as in
lip bumper.
Lip
so
bumper.
What happens is that there is a gap. Okay. See what happens here. This upper teeth. Okay. Basically, the biting will be done by the upper teeth, right? It will go and bite here. So what we do is we'll put one here, a cushioning effect from an acrylic material. We'll put a barrier, kind of barrier, so that it becomes difficult for the child to go forward and bite the lip. Alright? So this is called lip bumper. We are bumping this region so that he cannot go and bite it. Okay?
Okay. So doctor, now are there any motivational methods that parents can use in today's date when it comes to promoting tooth brushing in children?
Yes, but I must say Dr. Iman is already practicing it, right? See, this is a kind of reward chart that we can give to our children. So, see, there are varieties of reward charts in the online Google. You can Google it then. So what you can do is we can tell him that if you brush every day twice, okay, once in the night and once in the day, you can score yourself, you know, you can go and put a star or put a tick mark and we can keep a record. And what happens at the end of the week, after a week, you calculate those numbers and how many times your child was brushing, and on that we can reward him with simple, you know, simple mm-hmm. gifts. It need not be an expensive gift, a pencil or a rubber, you know, like that.
So personally, you would say that for every 7 days, mm-hmm. you should reward your child for brushing.
Yes.
And, you know, you should keep a check for every 7 days.
Yes.
See, it's always nice to have a short goal rather than have a big goal end of the month. You know, mm-hmm. short goal setting is very important for children to reach bigger targets.
Yes.
So it's like that. So we have many charts available which parents can put up on, you know, their refrigerator and ask the children. You have to color it every time you brush. So once they finish the 7 day, they'll say, Mama, I need my reward today. And for the reward, they will end up brushing 2 times a day. And even they should be a day when you don't even have to tell your child, please brush in the night, because they know there's a reward waiting for them end of the week. Okay. And when it comes to reward, please do not give them chocolates.
Yes.
Okay. Reward should be in the form of books that are, you know, that promote the child to understand some new concepts or some kind of what are the good rewards you would give your child?
Yes. A visit to the zoo, a visit to the museum. Something which is, you know, like with a lot of activity
that, you know, it intellectually stimulates your child. Okay. Mm-hmm. So rewards could be like that.
Okay.
So Mr. Indraneel is asking us, what is malocclusion? Kindly elaborate.
See, malocclusion is nothing, as I told you. It is the alignment of the teeth. Okay, when there is, the teeth are not aligned, okay, they are not positioned, they are not standing in his right place, this is malocclusion.
Something like this?
Okay, so occlusion is when each tooth is in the position, in the place where it should be, okay, and malocclusion is when it is not there, it is not sitting in the correct position.
Yeah, so this would be a malocclusion. When you say an open bite, it is a malocclusion. All right.
Anything else? Says okay. Prem Chandra has joined. Hi. Kavita.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining in today. I am Dr. Iman. And this is Dr. Anandita, senior periodontist. We are here to help you to understand the various techniques, the technology and the products that are available today in Partha Dental to help your child to improve his overall health. Okay. So please ask us as many questions as you want related to your child.
So as I think Chaitanya Chala is asking us how to reduce the thumb sucking habit to my kid. It is 7 years. Yes. See, thank you Chaitanya for asking that question. 7 years, as I told, till 4 years it is considered normal. After that, if your child is still on the thumb sucking habit, then we have different solutions to it. First is the simplest is only the thumb guard that Dr. Iman has shown. Can you show it again?
Yes.
Yeah. The thumb guard is nothing but thumb guard.
I have shown you the thumb guard. Sorry.
Yes.
Okay.
So the thumb guard is nothing but it's a covering. Okay. It's a material with which we will make the covering for the thumb. Okay. It is a customizable guard which we put on the child's finger or the thumb, and so that every time he puts it in the mouth, he will not have a very pleasant feeling. So eventually he will get rid of that habit, okay, because the child is on that habit because he seeks some kind of pleasure out of it. So once we stop that pleasure from the habit will be stopped.
Okay. Mr. Indraneel is asking us, can we give caps on milk too?
Yes, yes, definitely. That's what I said. Be it primary or the milk teeth or the permanent teeth, the procedure of caries, the process of caries is same. Okay, caries, if there is food accumulation, there will be caries and it has to go for a root canal treatment, which in primary teeth, we call it as pulpectomy.
Okay.
So once the pulpectomy is done, or the root canal treatment is done, just like for adults, how we place a cap to protect the tooth, we have to place a cap over the milk tooth as well. So we have different options for it. One is your stainless steel crowns, one is your zirconia crown. So according to the financial need, according to your requirement of the child, how conscious he is about his aesthetics, how conscious he is about his appearance, we can give the crowns. But crowns are very, very important to protect the milk.
Okay. Hello. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining in today. It has been a great pleasure being a part of this public awareness camp. Miss Poonam Rao is asking us, one of my nephew's teeth is in crisscross manner. Can he undergo clip treatment now? He's just 9 years old. Of course you can. We have all the solutions here in Partha Dental for you. And Dr. Anandita would be showing us
the pre-orthodontic trainer.
Pre-orthodontic trainer.
See, the thing is, Poonam, hi. I would like to know, we need to see how many teeth have erupted in his mouth, okay? As you are mentioning, he is 9 years old, but I believe he will be having a mixed dentition period. That is, his milk teeth are also present and his permanent teeth are also present. Now, if his milk teeth are still present, we can give a pre-orthodontic trainer. As I showed, this is a trainer to train the muscles and the position of the tongue in the mouth so that if there are minor alignment problems in the teeth, we can solve it. But as you're saying, it is in a crisscross manner, so I definitely need to see how severe the condition is. But yes, you can go for a adult orthodontics, that is your regular braces and the clips.
We have someone called as Miss Abhiruchi Gupta. Hello, ma'am. My 12-year-old daughter asked Miss Abhiruchi Gupta, my 12-year-old daughter has teeth which are aligned properly right now, but I don't see any spaces for wisdom teeth. Do I still need to get any braces consultation for her?
No, ma'am. See, ma'am, what you are asking is a very good question, because maybe she has undergone a wisdom tooth extraction. Maybe that's why she is conscious about it. It's a very, very thoughtful question, ma'am. So 12-year-old has still time for jaw expansion. She's still in the growing period. She's still in the growing age. So we cannot decipher or we cannot predict at this age that whether there will be place for the wisdom tooth or not. So eventually we'll come to know, but right now you do not have to go for any orthodontic consultation thinking about the wisdom tooth.
Okay. Mr. Indraneel is asking, can we treat nail biting habit in kids? What do you have to say for that?
Thumb guard, right?
Isn't have it a thumb guard?
Oh yes, one stop solution for tongue thrusting, thumb sucking, nail biting, all this. And there are chemicals also available, which are like bitter in paste and to stop. But I would say that it is better to go with the thumb guard. It's a very effective.
It's a very effective method to stop your nail biting or the tongue cribs. You have different options available, and we have it in Partha Dental. Hello, Mr. Rajkumar Bor. My friend Steve is half broken. Suggest me a best treatment. Sir, there are different kinds of, there's a different classification for trauma when it comes to broken teeth. We have to assess it properly. Okay, you have to come to us. The dentist has to clinically examine your child's teeth. Okay, if it is a small chip in your tooth, as in if it's a small chip in your tooth, then we can do something called as a composite filling. It's called a composite buildup, and we can cover the broken tooth. Okay. Now, if it still goes deeper, we have to do something like called as a pulpectomy or the pulpotomy, what Dr. Anandita was talking about.
But I think he is talking about adult patient.
My friend's teeth. Okay, right? It's adult teeth. So that goes to him as well.
So root canal treatment we have to do.
Yeah, we have to do a root canal treatment, and we have to go for a crown, a cap. Okay. Thank you so much for asking that question.
We can go for zirconia caps, which are very, very tooth-like, and they are very natural in look. So front teeth fractures, it's best to go for zirconia caps.
Thank you so much for asking that question. Mr. Indraneel is asking, what type of chocolates kids can have?
Okay. See, children can have chocolates. I am not against it at all. Only thing is that they should rinse the mouth properly once they have chocolates. Now, what type of chocolates you are seeing? We can give them sugar-free chocolates with xylitol. But I would say it is not very much advisable from my personal point of view. So it is always best to develop sweet intake in form of fruits, in form of little homemade cookies, in which we can control the sugar level. Okay, so there is nothing like we can give the child endless number of chocolates. It always has to be monitored.
Okay. Hello, Miss Amrita Rathore. My cousin had forwardly placed milk teeth. Will his permanent teeth also be forwardly placed, and can she immediately start treatment for the same? She is 7 years old now.
Hi, Amrita. Thanks for asking that question. Forwardly placed milk teeth is very rare, but it is not necessary that if your milk teeth are forwardly placed, your permanent teeth will also be forwardly placed. It is not necessary. As it is a transition period, the position of the teeth will change. Okay, so we have to wait till the permanent teeth erupt and to see how it is called the eruption guidance pathway, how it is erupted. Okay, and we can start treatment right after the eruption of the teeth at the 7 years old, 7 years age itself. Why? Because we, as I told earlier, we can go for interceptive orthodontics. It is something which we try to limit the malalignment, and as Indraneel was asking, malocclusion. Okay, so we can limit that forwardness of the tooth, and we can correct it at a tender age.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Anandita. Now, coming back to the facilities we have in Partha Dental. Okay, why is Partha Dental basically known as a brand? Okay, Partha Dental is a brand because there are certain factors where you have to consider before you call yourself a brand. All right. I could proudly say that we doctors from Partha Dental are working for a world-class brand because we have a website. We are vigilant, upgraded. We have a logo and we have the most advanced world-class technology. We have all licensed practitioners. Every doctor has to go through a series of tests and scrutiny before getting appointed in Partha Dental. And we have the cream of the dentist working for Partha Dental. So you are rest assured that you are walking into a branded clinic today, which is a need of the hour. Okay. So what impact does it make for a parent when he brings a child to a branded clinic?
Yes.
How different is it when you go in for a normal practice or when you know opt for a branded clinic like Partha Dental?
See, in Partha, we are having all kinds of facilities. We have insurance, camera, we have OPD machine right in the clinic. We don't send our patients outside to get the x-ray.
You're right.
We have all the necessary tools to motivate the child. So once we show with an intraoral camera, you know, that he has got a cavity in the child, believe me, the child will definitely say yes to the treatment. Because from my experience, what I have seen, even though we feel the children are not so conscious, they are very, very conscious.
Now, for instance, your child comes and sits on the dental chair, okay? He is scared. He's very fearful that, oh no, this doctor is going to use some sharp instruments and going to, you know, start off the treatment. So what we do is in Partha Dental, we first talk, we first counsel the child. That is a culture. And that is the culture for every patient in Partha Dental. So when you bring your child to us, the first thing would not be just to start the treatment, just to start drilling the cavity. We would first make the child sit and counsel him. We will show him such pictures of his own teeth. We would click pictures of the using the intraoral camera, show it on the screen and motivate the child. So half the work is done there. The child says, ew, you know, we have to get this filled. Mama, I want to get my cavity filled. So they will definitely say, no, I will do the treatment. So that is a culture in Partha Dental. We help the children to, you know, themselves come up and say that I want to get all my treatment done. So it's like a one-stop solution.
So nowadays we practice CMCR. This is chemomechanical caries removal. So what we do in that, basically, doctor, see, the child is scared of an aerator.
Okay.
The aerator is nothing but the tool which makes a lot of noise while drilling and making the cavity. So what?
Yeah, most of the time we hear a drill sound go, or the children just see a lot of water splashing and, you know, they get scared.
Yes.
So in Partha Dental, we have this technology called as the
chemomechanical caries removal, CMCR. So in this technique, what we do not use any tool, any instrument, any motor instrument, okay? Only hand instruments are used. So what we do is, first we will place the enzyme.
Okay? We place the chemical,
which is nothing but an enzyme. Okay, we have various companies like Papa Care, which use a papain enzyme, which is extracted from papaya.
It's a very natural. It's a very natural enzyme.
Product. Yes,
it's not chemical based.
Which is bromelain is extracted from pineapple because we keep in mind that it is being used for children, so we want to make it as natural as possible. So that enzyme will dissolve the infected part of the tooth. Okay, and once we can take it out, we can scrape it out with our hand instrument, we can fill it with the desired filling material. Yeah. So there will be no usage of any machine, any tool, there will be no noise, no water, no special. Child will be very, very comfortable. So it is our duty to, you know, and one more thing, it's a request to all the parents, you should not expect the child to, you know, come and sit in the dental chair and get the treatment done then and there, because today's parents are very busy. So I see many parents come to me and they say, everything you do it today itself. So I always tell them it is not possible. We need to make a friendly atmosphere, a friendly relationship with our child patient, and then only proceed with the treatment.
Yeah. Hello, we have a very curious audience today. Thank you so much for joining in. Ms. Indraneel asks us, do you have conscious sedation treatment in our hospital?
Thanks again, Mr. Indraneel. You are really making this show very interactive. I am liking it. So conscious sedation treatment in hospital, yes. First of all, I would like to tell my viewers what is the conscious sedation technique. Conscious sedation is nothing but the usage of nitrous oxygen, okay, nitrous oxide, to help sedate the patient, to relieve the anxiety and the fear on the patient while doing the treatment. But it is not yet started in Parker Dental, but very soon we will be getting the machinery and we will start doing.
We do have the facility, doctor. We do have the facility, as we have a tie-up with the hospital wherein we have the OT and we can organize treatments under conscious sedation.
For very uncooperative children, we can arrange it. Not an issue. But in a regular basis, it is. I would say my patients really love me, and it doesn't happen that I need to use that.
Okay. Thank you for asking the question. Do you treat autistic children?
Yes. Recently in Bellanzur, I have treated an autistic child, and we do also treat all kinds of special children, the cerebral palsy, autism, even physically challenged children.
Okay, that's great. So you treat children from all walks of life, like
yes. Okay. Children should be children. That's it. My patient should be a child, and I'm happy to work on them.
Okay, nice to know that. So Partha Dental does not discriminate. We take people from all parts of the world. We take people from all walks of life, and we have good communicators. We have very good system to make your whole dental procedure a cakewalk. So please walk in today and book your appointment with Partha Dental at our website www.parthadental.com, or call on our toll-free number 1-800-102-8686.
Rajkumar has joined us. Hello, Rajkumar. Sunanda, Srinivas, Sudhakar, Keshu. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Anandita, senior periodontist working for Partha Dental, Bangalore, India.
Okay. We have a question here. What if child faints during the treatment? What would you do, doctor?
Yes. So, first of all, we always give morning appointments for my children, for my pediatric patients, whom I have started considering my children itself. So we give morning appointments so that their child has a good breakfast, their child is less anxious state, and also his sleep will be completed and he'll be very fresh in the morning. Usually it will not happen that the child will faint, but even though if the child faints, so we take all kinds of precautions while doing the treatment. We use rubber dam, we use throat gauze so that no instrument is slipped inside the throat, or there should not be.
We take harmful. All precautions.
Yes, so nothing to worry about it. And yes, we have
the first aid kit. Yes. We have backup general physicians. We have all kinds of facilities wherein your child can be taken care of. And
any kind of emergency situation, be it syncope or hypoglycemia, we can take care of it right in the clinic. So nothing.
Classically, when a child faints, we use ammonia to sniff. Ms. Sunanda Paul is asking us, hi doctors, is it necessary to clean the gums and tooth of a newborn baby?
Yes.
At what age does the tooth come out of a newborn baby?
Okay, yes. Hi Sunanda, thanks for asking this question. Yes, it is very important to clean the gums and the tooth of a newborn baby. As of the knowledge, a newborn baby till 6 months will not have any kind of teeth in the mouth. But it is required to clean the gums, the gum bag. Okay. How will we do that? With the help of our finger. okay, what we are supposed to do, we will take a piece of gauze. Okay, I think every one of us know what is a gauze, right? We will take
piece of white cloth.
You can get a picture of that. So gauze piece we are going to tie up in the finger, okay, and the thumb, and we are going to do a front and back motion in the child's oral cavity on the gums. Okay, it is just to actually with that it also release the child of any kind of irritation or if any kind of food has accumulated there. Because I would say that till 6 months the child will be completely unbreastfed. So the milk may accumulate. Sometimes what happens, child will fall asleep while feeding. So we should make sure that, you know, that there is no milk left in the gum area.
Something like this, a gauze piece.
This is a gauze.
You get it in the medical shop. Yes. Okay.
So all the new moms and the new dads, they can buy a piece of gauze and you
cut
should
it, sterilize it.
Okay, you should put it in around your finger. You get a sterilized gauze right from the pharmacy, and if you're not sure about the sterilization, it's disinfection. Okay, so if you're not sure about it, you can boil it in 100 degrees Celsius boiling water.
You can just wipe
and wipe the child's gum.
Thank you so much.
No, I think she has another question. At what age does a tooth come out? It will be 6 months. Okay, it will be 6 months at which the first tooth will erupt. Okay, first your front lower teeth will erupt, then the front upper teeth, and slowly the entire 20 teeth will come as a primary dentition.
Okay. Now there are some people who are asking us questions about implants. So we will come back to the implants very soon.
Tanuja RJ has joined and asking, what are the methods you use to control child anxiety? And what should we do to train a child at home before the first dental visit? Yes. Hi, Tanuja. Thanks for asking that question. First of all, we should bring the child to a dentist at 6 months of age. Okay? Because as I told, there will be not much of dental problem there. But the child will get used to the environment, okay, the clinic. This is the first step of reducing the anxiety. Okay, second thing is, as you are asking, before the dental visit, what can be done? Yes, if your child is very small and he does not understand, but by 2 years of age, the child will start understanding that, you know, that he's been taken somewhere, he's been taken to a doctor, there have been injections. There's always this fear of injection. Okay, because right from the infancy time, the children are taken to the pediatricians, they are given vaccines. So they always associate this white coat with the injection. So all these things you have to explain. Nowadays in Google, we get this YouTube videos are there in which, you know, they show that the primary character, the cartoon character, goes to a dentist and, you know, so gets treatment done. Yeah. So all these things can be done, and also we should control the mother's anxiety, because most of the times what happens is my patient will be very calm and quiet. The mother will be crying.
The mother will be very tense. It's the mothers who are the
and cause. Because of the mother's anxiety, the child will start getting scared, because he thinks if the mother is scared, something scary is going to happen. So we should also control the mother's anxiety. That is very important.
Hello, Mr. Suresh Parimi has joined in. Shreya Srinivas, hello, ma'am. Ms. Shreya asks, please explain the advantages of fluoride application and how frequently do we avoid fluoride? How frequently do we advocate fluoride application?
Hi, Shreya. Advantages of fluoride application. As I said, fluoride is a very, very bonding material or bonding mineral, which goes and joins the tooth, okay? So the tooth and the fluoride will form a very hard surface, enamel surface, is fluoroapatite, and it is very acid resistant. So the attack, the caries attack, okay, or the decay attack will become difficult for on this hard surface. Okay. So it is a protective method, basically, from decay. And how often should we apply? It depends on, again, on what is the fluoride content we are using. There are different APF gel is there, fluoride varnish is there. Okay, there are different methods. But definitely every 6 months we should go for a fluoride application, so that, you know, there is a remineralization happening all the time in the mouth, and, you know, all the time there is a protective shield, okay, protective barrier over the teeth. So this is how we advocate the fluoride treatment. See, it's explained very, very simply. There is bacteria and there is food and there is the tooth. So when this bacteria will eat up this food which is accumulated on the tooth, what happens is acid is released. And this acid will cause, will degrade the enamel, will eat up the enamel, will cause the decay. Okay, they will form a ditch and will cause a decay. Now, when fluoride is there, what happens? This process, this attack, the bacteria eating the food and, you know, the acid is produced, this acid attack becomes very difficult. Okay, and it cannot go through that hard fluoride, fluoridated enamel. As a result, the decay is prevented.
Wonderful, doctor. Thank you so much. And next, Aisha Sabina. Hello, ma'am. Salaam alaikum. Mm-hmm. My kids are scared of dental treatment. What to do?
You should get him to Partha Dental. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Sabina, for asking that question. And yes, all of us, actually not only kids, even the adults, we are also scared to go to a dentist and keep the mouth open without knowing what is being done. So it's a very general tendency for the kids to get scared. But what I say, as I told in my earlier conversation, that you should show them this YouTube videos, the cartoon characters, you know, who goes to the, who visits the dentist, and you should also give your own example. You should show that, see, I had visited the dentist and there was no problem. You should always put
positivity towards dentists,
positive,
or doctors.
Outcomes, positive effects, and the child will definitely come, at least visit the dental clinic with a fresh attitude, with a positive attitude.
There are some books available in the market,
yes,
which you can read out to the child at a very early age. Some touch and feel books, some colorful books,
activity books. Yes.
So they develop a positive attitude. You know, they have a picture of an injection, or they have a picture of a dentist holding an instrument. They see the pictures and they get kind of used to it. It's not like first time they walk into a clinic and they see all this. They when they walk into the clinic, they'll already know all this, because the mother would have already read it out to them. Okay, this is going to be the experience and this is how, what is going to happen. So it's no big deal. You just have to walk in, talk to the dentist. The dentist is a normal person. You don't have to get scared. You don't. There's something called as white apron apprehension. It's a white apron phobia,
yes,
they say.
Yes.
So they get out of this these phobias, even just because the mothers read out to them at a very early age. So instilling a positive attitude towards a doctor will help you mothers in in the long run. So please find out various techniques to instill good habits in your child. I shall show you one more chart here. We have a chart for toothbrushing. We have a chart by Dr. Anandita had given me. Yeah, it's, you know, where the child can color. Once he finishes brushing, he can just color the circle and he says, see, I've brushed in the morning. And then in the night again, he takes a color pencil and brush, colors it, and he says, I brushed in the night. So he will be waiting for a reward towards the end of the week. So that way, the mother, smart mothers do a very good job with their children. Okay,
so you can inculcate good habits.
You mothers tell you one thing: please don't work hard. Please work smart. Please work smart.
Yes.
All right. So we have a lot of innovative techniques available. You just have to make some effort to come to Partha Dental and talk to us. We will counsel you. We are here 24/7. We are ready to give you, give out these ideas to you. So please book an appointment today. Mr. Ibrahim Ibn has joined us. Mr. Indraneel is asking us a question. Do doctor take the medication and injection if it's for, do doctors take the medication and injects it for teeth treatment, or hospital assistant does it? Okay, because I have seen wrong medicine being injected sometimes in some hospital. Okay, so Now, the first thing is, in Partha Dental, we do not allow any assistants to do the to give the medication or to instill the injection. Okay, when it comes to the child patients, she should be a better person to talk about it.
Mr. Indranil, all I can say is I can assure us no such thing will ever happen in Partha Dental. You can be 100% sure of it. And when I'm practicing, I make sure that everything goes well. I greet my children, patients, you know, pediatric patients right from the door. And I am the one who also gives the, you know, dispatch, we can say, from the dental chair. So you can be very, very assured that nothing of such sort will ever happen in Partha Dental.
Basically, your child will have a very pleasing, you know, fearless, painless treatment, and he will walk out happy. Ms. Sunanda Paul is asking us.
She's telling us. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor, for the wonderful information.
You're welcome, Sunanda.
It is our duty, Ms. Sunanda. And Mr. Indranil is asking, what to do if child gets...
Yes, the same question, fits, right? Fits of pains. Okay, as I am telling that we have all the emergency medical... we have all the kit and we have all the facilities to comply for any medical emergency situation in the clinic. So there's nothing to worry. We have all the supplies and we have all the medication, and we also are tied up with the hospital, because if it's a very, very emergency situation, we can also shift the child to our associated hospital. Great.
Thank you so much, everybody, for joining in. So Partha Dental has reached the zenith of dental practice in 2018. We have about 86 plus clinics and 300 plus doctors, specialist doctors, and we are well equipped with enough of intraoral cameras, and we have the OPG machines, we have the RVGs, the radio visual graph, we have intraoral periapical x-rays, and a very well trained staff.
Laser
equipment.
Because nowadays people are very, very interested in laser.
Yes.
So we do have laser.
So,
treatment.
Doctor, what are the laser treatments we can do for kids?
For kids. Actually, I would say that yes, we can do laser treatment for kids, pulpectomy, the regular procedure. Root canal treatment can be done with laser. But as of such, I don't practice laser for children as of yet, because it is not much required.
Okay.
But yes, the treatment options are available.
Okay, thank you so much. And thank you so much for joining in, Mr. Jay Ranya, Radha Krishna, Dananjaya. And here we have Mr. Avinash Verma. Hello, sir. Hi, doctor. Dr. Avinash, Mr. Avinash, do we have separate toothpaste for kids? So how to select a good toothpaste for kids?
Yeah. Hi, Avinash. Welcome. Thank you so much for asking that question. It's a very, very important question, and I'm sure a lot of our viewers would like to know that. So children before 5 years of age are supposed to use non-fluoridated or reduced level of fluoridated toothpaste. Till 3 years of age, no need of using any fluoridated toothpaste. Fluoridated toothpaste, as I was saying, that is the fluoride. When your toothpaste has fluoride, it is called fluoridated toothpaste. Till 3 years of age, it is not required. Okay, so we get toothpaste in the market. I would not like to take the brand names, but you know, it would be unethical here. But yes, you can go to the pharmacy and look out for toothpaste which do not contain fluoride. Okay, those are for 3 years. Now, from 3 years to 12 years, we should use fluoridated toothpaste with a reduced amount of fluoride, that is 500 ppm.
500 ppm.
Okay, you should all, whenever you are buying the toothpaste, I don't know if you guys have checked your own toothpaste. Like for us, it is 1000 ppm. Okay, it is 1000 ppm of fluoride should be present in your toothpaste to have that anti caries activity or the anti caries effect. For children from 5 years, from after 3 years, like 4 years to 12 years, we should use in the range of 500 ppm. There are many, many toothpaste available in the market today with different flavors and with different colors to make it very attractive to the kids.
So it is it will be very, very helpful for your child if he starts using this fluoridative toothpaste from the age of 4. And also, it's a humble request, do not give your own toothpaste to the child because it has a higher amount of fluoride in it. Okay? With the toothpaste that we use has 1000 ppm of fluoride, which is excessive for the child. So you should always have two toothpaste in the home, one for your kids and one for yourself.
All right. So Mr. Indraneel is asking,
do you have Papo's boards in your hospital? Mr. Indraneel, thank you for asking that question. Yes, we do have Papo's boards in our hospital, but usually we do not use it. It is not required. I don't believe in aversive conditioning. We do not believe in, tying up. For the other viewers, I would like to say, what is a Papo's board? It is nothing. It's a restraint. It is a restraint. Okay. It is used to tie the patient when he is not very cooperative with the treatment. Now, as I said, I had an autistic patient, I think 1 month back, right?
Yes.
Yes. Uh-huh. 1 month back. For him also, we did not use a Papo's board. His parent was very, very apprehensive. He was asking me because he went to one clinic, and that clinic person, the clinician, told him that he needs to use restraints for the child, and the parent did not approve of it. So okay. He came to Partha Dental. The first question he asked me, how are you going to treat my child? Are you going to use any physical mm-hmm. restraint? Mm-hmm. My answer was no. And believe me, the parent was so happy because mm-hmm. no parent wants his child to be, tied to a chair. And, they want love and care. And yes. I can assure you in Partha and with me, there is always a very, very...
You're in safe hands.
Yes. There is always no need of any restraint.
So he's asking how you read this?
Yes. How to tell if the child is really crying during the treatment or the child is acting? Yes. It is like we can do a positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement. So what happens in this? Mm-hmm. If the child is actually having pain, what will happen when you stop the treatment? He still will have lingering pain, okay? He will still be insisting on going. He will be still be insisting to stop the procedure, okay? But if the child is acting, he is just, out of anxiety, out of fear, or he's not interested in the treatment, if he's just acting, then he will immediately stop crying. It is called negative reinforcement. Once we remove the aorta, or once we remove the whatever procedure, we stop the procedure, he'll immediately stop. And with clinical experience and with so many years of practice, I think we will know when the child is crying and acting.
Thank you so much for joining in, everyone. Mr. Kumar Naveen, Kotapalli Kiran, Shankar Reddy, Shavanti Tupa, Sudhir Simhadri, thank you so much for joining in. Mr. Raman Rahman asked, how about conscious sedation in the management of child patient, madam? Is it safe?
Yes, yes. Hi, Rahman. It is safe. We can safely use conscious sedation for children who are apprehensive and who are little uncooperative, who are having anxiety during the treatment. We can definitely use it. It is very safe.
Okay. He also asked management of Down syndrome patient.
Yes.
What do we have?
Yes, as I told at Partha Dental, we always are available. We are always welcoming specially challenged children. So the special treatment children, it's a different procedure. It depends. It varies from child to child. Down syndrome children, we usually see there is malocclusion, that is a malalignment. The teeth will not come in the proper space. There will be narrow arches.
Okay.
This growth will be little restricted. Then there is also lot of caries and decay in special treatment need children. Okay. Because they are not able to, clean the teeth by themselves. They're hesitant. And their food habits will be very, little irregular, not consistent. So, yes, there will be a lot of caries. But we do treat all kinds of children. And there is no discrimination. I have done a lot of pulpectomy procedures. I have placed crowns in Down syndrome children. And I'm telling you once, it's a basic treatment. The treatment is same. Only thing is about the management. And once these children become friendly to the dentist, the treatment becomes really easier.
So basically, I would like to stress on one of the cases that had come to Partha Dental, where the child had multiple number of caries, and this is what the change that we saw. So, Dr. Anandita, whenever a child has multiple caries, it's called as rampant caries, right?
Yes.
So,
yes.
How can we prevent that, and what are the measures a dentist can use to help such a child?
Yes. See, rampant caries or early childhood caries, what happens in all the, in this situation, many of the multiple teeth will get affected. Now, to prevent it, as I already told, that fluoride application, regular visit to your dentist, you know, improvement into dietary habits, all this will help out to prevent this caries. Also, there is one caries called nursing bottle caries. So, you should never, never leave a bottle, okay, bottle of milk or bottle of sweetened juices in the mouth of the child for a long period.
Okay.
So
basically, we should not give the child milk with sugar, white sugar especially. White sugar is very harmful. Okay, so it's always better to get your child used to having milk without sugar. As soon as you start weaning,
you're withdrawing your child from the breastfeed.
Yes. Okay. So as soon as you start weaning, you're supposed to start giving the child foodstuff which are not having very lot of sugar content,
like pureed stuff. Like in South Karnataka, we give ragi.
Ragi.
Mm-hmm. Mostly we give ragi. But in Kerala, we give mashed bananas, right?
Yeah, so, baby bananas.
Yes. So like this, you know, you have to change the food habit to avoid rampant caries. But if your child is already having rampant caries, then no issues. We can do pulpectomy and we can restore the beautiful smile with zirconia crowns, which are tooth color, very natural looking. And there will be no psychological hindrance because of the decay.
All right. So basically, doctor, there's this Matla Rajkumar. Hello, sir. We have been wanting to answer you from a long time. Mr. Matla Rajkumar is asking us, we want implantation of teeth, madam. Yes, sir. We will provide you all kinds of dental implants in Partha Dental, and it is a completely safe procedure. And we are a very cost-effective clinic, a set of clinics when it comes to placement of implants. Okay. So usually people have this notion that implants are costly, and how am I going to afford implants? Nay, I'll go in for something removable, or I'll go for something called as, you know, bridge. So it is completely a cash-free facility that we have in Partha Dental. We have all kinds of options like Bajaj FinServ, or we have Capital Float, okay, wherein you can afford any kinds of implants, and we will help you to decide your budget for the implant, and we will give you a proper time schedule as for how many sittings it will take. So you have not provided us any information about the number of teeth that you want to go for implantation. So please walk in today to Partha Dental. We have our branches all over South India.
He's asking for all teeth.
He's asking for all the teeth.
That
so,
is also possible.
Yeah. So recently we had a case in Partha Dental wherein we did implant and crown fixation for all the teeth. And it's 1 second, sir.
So only thing is the number of implants will change. If it's a full mouth implant case, basically we need 6 implants in the upper jaw, that is your floor, and 6 implants in the lower jaw.
Yeah.
Okay. It depends from person to person, depending on the bone density. So there is a lot of factors involved. And once you come to Partha Dental, we check everything that is complementary. All the checkup that we do, the bone density we will check, your positioning of the bone we will check, your nerves where they are placed check. Everything is taken into
control.
Typically,
we need to
take
a proper X-ray to assess, your bone density, and your overall medical health has to be looked into. So a proper planning is very essential, sir, to go in for a full mouth implants and bridge placement. Thank you so much for asking that question. Thank you so much for joining in, everyone, today. This show is looks very lively.
And I'm really feeling very nice. There's so many questions.
Yes. Okay, thank you so much for thanking us, Mr. Avinash.
Thank you. Thanks to you too. I hope it was useful and, you know, informative for you guys.
And we have Mr. Indraneel, who is asking us, which is better, manual or electric toothbrush for children below the age of 10?
Yes, I would always say that, you know, manual toothbrush is good, because if we use an electric toothbrush, what happens, this motion, okay, this motion of the to and fro motion that we use with the toothbrush, the child will not experience. And the tactile sensation, now what is the tactile sensation? It's the feeling of the surface with your hand, okay? He will not understand how much pressure to apply while brushing, okay? But for special need children, electric toothbrush is more advisable, because they don't know how much pressure to apply. So it is always better to go for the electric toothbrush for special need children.
Okay. So now coming to the various treatments done in Partha Dental, we have done the maximum number of implants in almost all the clinics in Partha Dental, and we have the highest number of smile designs, wherein we give crowns and we do implants. We do a multidisciplinary, we have a multidisciplinary approach towards all our patients. Okay, but the normal culture is that first we treat your chief complaint. We we first listen to our patients. We listen to their complaints. First, we make sure that we solve your problem. And we also make sure that we guide you towards a better oral hygiene. You know, supposingly you have a missing tooth and you don't have a problem about this in so many years. But when you walk into Partha Dental, we will, you know, tell you the pros and cons of having a missing teeth and, you know, how it impacts your other teeth. So supposedly we have a missing tooth here. Okay, we have a missing tooth. So in case you have a missing tooth here and the opposing tooth is there, okay, that tends to erupt if the opposing tooth is missing, and the adjacent teeth also tries to shift in that position. So over a period of time, maybe today you don't have a problem with it, but over a period of time, you tend to, you know, lose your, masticatory,
the
muscle elasticity.
You start looking a little older than your age. You know?
Yes.
So a lot of things come into effect.
Yeah. So we give you a complete treatment solution. Okay, it is a one-stop solution. Partha Dental is a one-stop solution. Okay, so please do walk in today to our clinics. Book your appointments, logging into www.parthadental.com. And please call to a toll-free number to talk to a dentist, 1-800-102-8686. We have our call center working 24/7 just for you all. And we welcome people to call us and ask us questions. We are always here to help you, to guide you and to educate you about the various treatments that are available in Partha Dental. And talking about upgradation, every clinic of ours has a standard that is followed, which is set forth by our beloved MD, Dr. Partha Sarathy, who had followed these, you know, basic standards of practicing dentistry 20 years ago. Okay, 20 years ago, he started his clinic in Tirupati, and he had these basic principles that he has to give the best of the best treatment for the common man, be it a rich person or a poor person. I am going to only give the most advanced, I'm going to give the most advanced facilities to my people. Basically, we love our country, right? So we are giving the best that we can in our limits. And in future also, we will continue to do the same. Almost all the clinics in Partha Dental are very well upgraded, and the infrastructure is in par with the clinics in US or UK or the developed countries. All right. And when it comes to using various upgraded dental products, of course, we have our own store wherein we get all the products and which are upgraded. We get products from all over the world, the best of the best in the market for you all. And we don't compromise in quality. All right. So that's the reason why the whole world calls us a brand. All right. So much for the publicity. We are actually worth crores of rupees when it comes to infrastructure, the marketing team. We have good strategy. We motivate our patients to get the best, but not, you know, just be a mediocre and opt for something, you know, lesser than what they can afford. Okay, so when I talk about cost effectiveness is something that we follow as, you know, as proud Parthians. All right, we give you solutions from different categories. We give you grade A, B, C categories. We give you treatment options wherein you have to choose. You have to choose what you want to do. We tell you this is, you know, grade A, B, C treatment. So what do you want to opt for? Okay, but all the solutions will be right for you. All the solutions will be right for you.
Range.
It's just that we give you a range
for making customer friendly. You know, so I feel that you should definitely come today itself to our clinic, get a checkup done, because you never know what's going inside in your mouth, because we don't see it. If it is external problem, we see it and we know that we need to go to the doctor. But when it is inside the mouth, we don't know. So it is very, very important for you to go to the clinic. So do visit Partha Dental, and you can also email to us, or you can have all your questions asked even after the program. I'll be very happy and delighted to answer all your questions, all your doubts. Don't keep any doubt in your mind. We are here to solve it.
Especially when it comes to our children, we cannot compromise on their health.
Because they are the future of this country, right?
Yeah. So thanks for asking all the question, audience.
Okay, thank you everyone who have joined us today. It has been an excellent session. I really, really had a very good time.
Very delighted to have, you know, answer all your questions. We are still not running out of energy, though we are running short of time. All right. Yes. What is correct age for braces treatment for children? Doctor.
Yes, I've already answered that question.
Okay.
But I would like to answer again. The thing is, I would say that after the eruption of the canine, that's what I was telling, once your cornerstone teeth here, yes, they will erupt by the age of 12. It is advisable to go after the age of 12 for adult orthodontics or the braces. But there are certain cases in which we have seen the development will be a little earlier. Mm-hmm. Okay, the adult teeth, the permanent teeth will come a little earlier age. Then also we can start from 9 to 10 years also.
Okay, we have something left to tell you. We have the atraumatic restorative technique.
Yes, yes.
Okay. This is nothing but it refers to using hand instruments,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Such as we have a spoon excavator or to remove the caries. We use cements like glass ionomer cement, wherein the child has a painless cavity preparation. We do not actually put the child through a lot of trauma to do a cavity filling. So it's atraumatic restorative technique.
Basically, we use material which is bonding to the tooth directly. Okay, so that there is no extra work to be done on the tooth. It's a self-adhering or self-bonding. Okay, it will just go and stick to the tooth basically. So as I said, for more advanced, we use CMCR, the chemomechanical caries removal. So it is a very painless procedure for the child, and it is a very good step to introduce your child to the world of dentistry.
I mean, can you imagine coming to a dentist and there's no noise, no vibrations,
no pain,
no anesthesia, and high patient acceptance? You know, the child happily keeps his mouth open because he's not having any pain. So mothers, please book an appointment with us today to have this kind of a treatment. Our treatment for children is completely painless, and your child will walk out completely happy with a big smile on the face, and we make sure that they come back to us. Okay, we have seen children grow with us. Okay, we have seen children who have been coming to us consistently over many years, and we have treated them and they are very happy. They have, you know, we could avoid many, complications like, open bites, alignment, anything that related to alignment of the teeth, open bites, thumb sucking, or you know, lip biting or slurring of the speech, anything that you may not notice, we can notice.
Yes.
So please walk in today to our clinics. Now we are very sad to come to the end of this show.
Yes.
But I would like to also tell you something that you know, to do a treatment in Partha Dental, you really don't need to have a lot of money in your pocket. All right, you can just walk in without any cards or cash in your hand and get the treatment today with us. And we provide you cashless facilities. We have the Bajaj FinServ who give our patients a special loan up to 1.5 lakh for 0% interest, 0% on the down payment. And you know, it's like we don't take down payments from you. It's you just have to pay for the treatment cost in 8 parts. All right, they have an 8x0 scheme. So if you opt for Bajaj FinServ, you have to just pay for the treatment cost in a period of 8 months. But the best part is you don't have to pay up in the same month.
If you can get your treatment and pay later, basically.
Yes, and we have the capital float as well. So if you walk into Partha Dental, we give you two options, Bajaj and capital float. So you can opt to go in for an immediate treatment without paying anything today. And in the following months, you will have to just follow up with the payment just for the treatment cost. All right. And so
you don't have to, you know, save the money and go through that painful, you know, experience. You know, you don't have to go through that suffering. You can directly come here, get your treatment done, and you can pay in
installments. So Partha Dental here practices world-class dentistry, and we welcome all our patients from India and abroad to please come to us today and get your treatment done. In case you have anything related to corrective surgeries, orthognathic surgeries, or you want braces, or you want clear aligners, you want treatment for your children, and any kind of advice, you are always welcome. So this is Dr. Iman signing off today from Partha Dental Bangalore, and
I'm Dr. Anindita. And please come to our clinic with your children. I'd love to treat them. So here we are, winding up the show. Thank you.
Thank you so much.